No! That's not how... Yeah, I guess. I can also try to finish him. That's not... I had the wrong scene loaded. Anyway, welcome to the fourth round of the Legacy Challenge. We are up against Dark Vonix. He used to play some kind of weird four-color Planeswalker artifact control deck, which should probably be good for us. Like, traditionally, anything that's based on Deck Faden has been a really great matchup for Elves. Just ask Joe Lossett. He always complains, like, when he plays that kind of Tesserator deck, I always have this in my opening hand, and once again I do. But could be something entirely different, like, Pulled Delta doesn't really give away a lot of information. Whereas Basic Forest into Nettle Sentinel, yeah, that must be Merfolk, right? Let's see. I actually have the list pulled up here, and... this list runs Polluted Delta, so it's probably some kind of top to Foundry Chalice, Force Deck, Tesseract Deck Faden, Bafo Strix, what have you. Oh, Fatal Push. Okay, forget this. Looks like Bugdelver. And him. Please take the Reclamation Sage. Yes. Okay, that's probably the best outcome for the him we could have wished for. I'm leading with the Aquarian Ranger because it's slightly more important. Because it protects the Bayou. So I'd rather not have it dazed, and then I'm following up with like the second best creature. Technically the best creature in the long run, since it deals 2 damage and attacks past Death by Chairman. But in this context, this is much more important, so if this gets dazed, that's okay. And if it doesn't get dazed, we start getting in for damage. And damage is good, you know. So he's probably like, is this worth the daze or is it not? I can't tell you. Like, from my perspective, I'd rather have this resolved, but I don't know. Sometimes you also have to consider, like, he's only got 4 cards, so maybe he wants to keep the days to pitch to Force of Will, maybe he wants to shuffle it away with Brainstorm, maybe he doesn't have it, maybe he just went away and came back to his computer and he was like, oh yeah, sure, that resolves. We don't know. By the way, I really love how these are starting at 5 PM for me in Europe now, these Legacy Challenges, because unless I top 8, which is always welcome, I'm actually done much earlier than I used to be when they started 3 hours later. So that's a big plus. And I also like that these are going to be weekly things from now on. Okay, that's a great one. This opens up a lot of great top decks. Basically 8 great top decks. But even Glimpse gets much better once you have Firewood Symbiote. Since he didn't play another Cavotherapy, I'm not going to play the Cradle yet. Since he didn't play another him. I really like to set it up in a way that when I do... let's do it like this. When I do play the Cradle, I immediately get some use out of it. And right now I'm pretty far from that. Also, we haven't given him an opportunity to Wasteland yet. I guess we kinda have, because he could have also Fatal pushed this and then Wastelanded us. But okay. 3 mana. That's weird. I mean, Liliana is horrible here. It's like 3 mana, gain 1 life, and... Oh, Shardless. Oh, okay, Shardless back. Ah, him. Ah. That could be worse things to happen to us, because right now we still have tons of mana. Oh, nice. Should I wait a turn or should I not? I'm probably not gonna wait a turn, because that makes it more likely for him to draw a Force of Will or another discard spell. Even though we are already, like, past 2 hymns. And then hopefully we're gonna draw, I don't know, Natural Order maybe? Well, Deathrite. Oh, that means we get to continue the Glimpse chain. I totally forgot. I was like, oh, okay, Deathrite is still good here, but we also, like, it's a Deathrite that draws a card. That's, like, the best kind of Deathrite. And... miss. Ah, it's okay. You could make a case for me bouncing one of my elves at the opponent's end of turn before I draw the glimpse, because I couldn't attack with a Heritage Shoot anyway. On the other hand, if this is in play, yeah, I should have done that. Even if I draw Natural Order, I could have still like replayed this guy, tapped for 3, 4, sacrificed this, untapped this. Yeah, I should have. So I would have gotten another draw. Okay, Cradle. Tarmogoyf? Probably? Okay. Big bad, stupid Tarmogoyf. So now at this point we have to wonder, is it gonna be okay? Because if I draw heritage, no. Okay, that's actually fine, I think. I was wondering if I draw Behemoth, whether I needed this to hardcast Behemoth until 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, but I don't. He's down to 3 cards, so most likely one Force of Will we have to beat, which means we have to either draw one big guy or something that's just not insane enough for him to just let it slip through. Let's see. Also, like, having a second bar here would not be bad, but I think overall I'd rather have to draw it. But having a second bio for more Deathrite Shaman activation definitely means something. Because right now we can do a double, yes, but then the second bio is tapped. Then we do this, this, yeah. So we definitely have... Okay. Even better, I guess. So let's do this proactively. I'm gonna take out... usually try taking out the sorceries first. Because the... Oh, and I'm gonna put Nettle Sentinel into play. Yeah. Because the idea is... he can't surprise you with Deathrite Shaman. Oh, let's see, let's do it like this, this, this. He can't surprise you with growing Tarmogoyf once, like, if there's a sorcery missing, that's okay. Oh, did I use this already? No, I don't have to. Whereas if you take out all the instants and then at some point you let Tarmogoyf, like, attack you and then he actually kills you because he adds a sorcery to the, an instant to the graveyard, that's something he can do, and that's something I usually try to avoid. And then I can untap this again. Yeah, okay. So that way I get to either shut down this Deathrite Shaman, or if I really want to, I can also also activate Deathrite Shaman as his end of turn, which he will then counter. And since there's not a lot of instant sorceries in the graveyard, I think I'm just gonna wait for my turn because I want to get all of them. The only card I'm really afraid of here around now is Toxic Deluge. And I wonder whether I can set it up in a way that Tarmogoyf, like I take Tarmogoyf with me. No, there's no way. I would need to eat the entire, like all graveyards for Tarmogoyf to die to a Toxic Deluge for 2. On the other hand, Toxic Deluge for 2 wouldn't be the end of the world because we get to keep Dryad Arbor and then either Deathrite, depending on whether he does it right now or not. He can actually force me into a really weird tox like thing if he attacks here and I block with Nettle Sentinel and bounce and then he goes for Toxic Deluge, then I have Nettle Sentinel, which is really not the kind of card I want to have post Toxic Deluge here. Also, I could like not block, or at least not block bounce, because then he can kill Deathrite Shaman with Abrupt Decay. But if he has Abrupt Decay, he would... well, maybe he really wants to get Deathrite Shaman, because he could Abrupt Decay this right now. And that's okay value, but okay, well, this, I guess he can sit behind it for a while. Sacrifices a creature. My first idea is to sacrifice the Heritage Steward, yeah, and I'm gonna go for that. That means I can't hardcast Krautdorf Behemoth anymore, but it's too unlikely. And if I draw natural Sentinel, Julian, come on. What's this? Okay. If I draw Natural Order, that's still castable, and if I draw Senate, I want to get Visionary anyway. So yeah. Okay, let's see. I don't hate trading here. The thing is, if I tap this, then he counters, then I untap, tap this, then and then I... yeah. Yeah, I think I'm gonna do it like this. Just this. And then I try to eat a land. Oh, he lets me do that? Okay, that's weird. Oh, maybe he has Fatal Push, but I can still counter that. And then I'm gonna take away one more sorcery. Oh, Cradle, huh? So much for not having enough mana. Okay, let's keep doing this. Or should I try to kill Liana here? I can't really do that because I would need to suicide these two and then lose this, or suicide this into this and this. No, no, I can't make him lose Liana, but that's okay. Cast this. And then use this and this. Or actually. Yeah, it's okay. Bounce this. And cast this. And now technically I could activate it again to gain life, but that's bad in this spot because I'd rather use the activation of Nettles. Okay, so what I could have actually done as well is, oh no, this was, yeah, so I could have run in this and the Deathrite Shaman, and then he puts this on the Deathrite Shaman, then I bounce the Deathrite Shaman, and then this dies to this, and basically I could sacrifice my current ranger to kill Liliana here, but I think it's actually not worth it. Also, I didn't think of the line at the time. Probably because it didn't like occur to me that it would be worth it in the first place. Because we would give up all of the Deathrite Shaman activations that we had this turn. And, like, Liliana isn't really doing much here. Shardless Agent, okay. Show us some more cards. Preferably another Liliana or Baleful Stick. Oh, Toxic Lucha's gun. At least one of them to the bottom. Perfect. And you got another bird. Okay. More birds and Grey Ogres. That's the kind of magic I want to play against this deck. Yes, discard. Could you discard an instant sorcery? Tarmogoyf. Yeah, these guys really aren't very great in the matchup. I wonder whether he attacks. Yeah, he does. Putting this on this again. Oh, yeah, so if I try to go for it, you can actually counter by gaining life, but I think that's okay. It also taps his... can I kill the Tarmogoyf? Actually, if I don't block here, and I remove another land... So, right now I remove a land, then I bounce block. Okay, technically I could kill the Tarmogoyf, but there's infinite things that could go wrong. Like, I can untap with the Quirion Ranger, eat another land, and then untap with the Wildwood, eat another land, bouncing the Quirion Ranger, and then the Tarmogoyf is 1-2, because there's only creatures in the graveyard. But if he has anything, then I lose a lot. Because then I lose a land drop, and I don't have this guy in play anymore, and I lose a Nettle Center, but maybe it's worth it, I don't know. I don't hate it. Let's see, I'm gonna add black first. The upside is that I get to keep this in play. Maybe that's not even good enough. Maybe I'm actually gonna do that. Just if he has a prop decay, but he would have a prop decay the Wildwood Symbiote anyway, wouldn't he? Then I'm gonna add green. And then do it like this. Man, this could go so wrong here. But I really wanna do it. And then I'm gonna add what would be the most confusing for him. Blue. Not that it would really be confusing. And then we just eat the Tarmogoyf. Great success. Elves is great, even though like that wasn't even a huge victory anyway. I mean, you already saw that he discarded the other Tarmogoyf because he really didn't need it. So now we can kill Liliana by sending in this guy and this guy. That's not, still not good enough. So I could send in these two and this, but then we just put it to one. I think it's still fine to just like sit behind here. Basically, we are drawing towards hopefully hitting like two really good creatures. I'm gonna go with this. And then eat some Tarmogoyf. And then this, and this. Yeah, the idea is to eventually find two spells that he wants to counterspell, or at least like one spell that he wants to counterspell, and then something that's good enough. Like a vision, like Visionary would be huge here, but so would Natural Order, Behemoth, Glimpse. Yeah, those are the cards we really want to draw. That's like 4, 8, 10, and then probably 4 more. Yeah, 14. Oh, and then there's Glimpse. There's 3 more of those, so 17. 70 cards out of 43, which we really want to draw. I like those odds. Yeah, no second Dryad Arbor for me. I'm okay. Like, him discarding cards pretty much helps me as well, because it keeps his ways of interacting low, but I guess he doesn't really have many ways of interacting anyway. And if he casts something here, that means he doesn't have Force of Will, which would be huge. Maybe he has him now, and he really wants to get rid of that last card. No, but then he would... Okay, now this reduces our outs significantly. At least that... But it also increases our outs that kill on the spot. Like anything that involves Natural Order, Behemoth, Senate. Okay, interesting. So if I bounce... Assuming I bounce this and then I draw Behemoth, then I've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Yeah, I actually do have 9. Even if I... Yeah, so let's just do it like this. Or what happens if I keep this in play and then attack next turn? I send like this, this, and this at Liliana. Now he's got too many creatures that dominate our creatures. I guess I could try to gain life here. Green. And then this and this. And then if he tries to counter that, then we might have a much better attack on Liliana. Let's see. Also, how come we are behind on time? Oh, maybe I'm explaining too much. Okay, let's just draw something that's really big. Okay, this is great. I think I had enough. Like, when I counted it in the previous turn, I had enough. So I've got 5, 6. Oh no, I counted this as a land drop, and we're okay, so it might not be enough. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 denied. 8, 9. Okay, no, that's right, but do we have enough creatures in play? We probably do. Even though this one can't attack, so this can attack. Actually, only these two can attack, but that... No, yeah, yes. Okay, sorry. Let's just do 5, 6, 7, 8, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 denied, nine, and then 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 10. Yeah, should be enough. Okay. Also, I don't even need to do it this way. I can also just untap the Dryad Arbor. Oh, but he's giving me it to me for free. That's even better, I guess. And then I do it like this. Why? Yeah, I didn't even need to use the Death Eye Chain for this. I totally forgot. So the opponent actually didn't see a single Force of Will. Too bad.
Finish him!
And we're gonna end this game the way we started it, by finishing him.
Battle cruiser operational.
And then we can even untap our Deathwatch Shaman by bouncing this. No! Oh, I should have waited for the trigger. Ah, fuck, I thought the trigger already resolved. Not that it matters, but yeah, that was like really bad. And then we're gonna send everything at the opponent. So 28 or something. Dark Onyx. That's like 12, 22, 28, yeah. Finished him.
Fatality.
Okay, so Shardless Buck, huh? We definitely need these because of Leovold, and this is also really nice against him. I mean, really nice, probably pushing it, but turning off all Tarmogoyfs is good. And in the past, I actually did this and had great success with it. But maybe this actually isn't good enough. Okay, let's see. I kind of like keeping this because it takes out his random birds and his shardless agents. Like you've seen in this board, this would have actually been a really good draw. It also takes out random cages, so I feel it's good enough. And then, like, you can always, when you're playing four, this is the beauty of it. When you're playing four of the core elves, you can always take out one of them, and that makes sideboarding much easier. Which is like why what I really like about this version, which is also like why I keep in Death Natural Order much more often than I used to in the versions where you only had like a couple of them, and then you often went down to two of them in games, and then Natural Order became much more of a liability. Whereas here, I kind of like where I am. The only other card that I like putting in, I think Reed Duke also plays that against Shardless Bug, is to use these for their sweepers or like the big payoff cards. Not that there are many, but it's nice to just one black remove them. Overall, I always like this card against blue decks, especially when they have Force of Will, always feels like a bit, leaves something to be desired often, but sometimes you also just seeing their hand gives you so much more information. It's super valuable because you know whether you can commit to the board or not, or like what to play around. And once you like, it's super easy once you know how to do that, unless they have like the busted draw where they go like Tarmogoyf, 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 Toxic. It's like, okay, GG, I'm out. And even then you get to take the Toxic Luch, I guess. So you really don't want to see double Toxic. Anyway, we have to take out one more card. This is, by the way, horrible against Leowild. Maybe the second Nidalee Sentinel. Because it's the card that does the least on its own, of its own, and yeah. I still kind of like it because it attacks past Deathrite Shaman and pressures Liliana, but I can't take out the Scavenging Ooze, it's too good against them, and so is the rest. So let's roll with this. I wonder what, at one point in the future, somebody will put a put down a compilation of all the ways I've sideboarded against all the different decks, and they are totally incoherent and completely different. And yeah, usually that's a sign that either you're building your deck wrong or you still haven't figured out the best way to play against them. But I'm really not a big fan of providing one-to-one sideboard guides, like sideboard guides, sideboard like this, sideboard like this, sideboard like this. I really don't like doing that because there's sometimes tiny little things that change, even not only between rounds, but actually between games in a match. Which require you to adapt to that, and that makes it much harder to put down a real sideboard guide. Like I could give you something like a sideboard guide in the blind, like when you really have no idea what you're doing and you probably want to go for something that's decent, then you do it like this. But overall, in me, I feel like I really want to do that. Oh, him, please don't him away. I guess that's okay. Him. I'm still gonna play this. Because I'm gonna need the mana next turn. By the way, I didn't play the fetch land on the first turn because I didn't want my opponent to be able to, like, if he didn't have the fetch land, then he couldn't have had three mana on his turn. Unfortunately, he had, and usually most of the time they have, but if you can help it, it's better to play something that doesn't turn on the Deathrite Shaman. The downside, of course, being that you can get wastelanded, but yeah, I mean, that's what I meant earlier by like you're not playing around everything. If your deck allows you to play around everything, your deck is probably too strong and boring. So that's really the big beauty about Magic and especially Legacy is like you're never really playing at 100% odds. You never really know what's happening. You're always playing like the 60 odd against the 80% odd, and it's beautiful because it's super challenging and something that also causes frustration and being like on top of that and being able to play through that insecurity. No, it's not an insecurity, like that risk and that lack of confidence of what's actually happening. Oh, by the way, that's what's making things really beautiful. Okay, actually mine's not weird, but I actually love this position because basically all we need to draw now is like one more land or and then an elf. Because we can abrupticate this and then probably resolve Natural Order. Unless he hits something crazy off the Shardless Agent now. Deathrite Shaman, that's okay. Even the Wasteland, like had he hit the Wasteland, that would have been much more problematic. But maybe he still has it. No, probably not. I did bring in Progenitus, did I not? Yeah, I did. It's unfortunate if he has Liliana, but they usually side them out, even though, like, on the play, I would definitely keep them in, because turn one Deathrite Shaman, turn two Liliana, it's just... It kills us. It's really, like, insanely good. Okay, so next turn we can end of turn Abrupt Decay the Gravedigger's Cage if we have to. Hopefully we'll draw a land next turn and Nettle Sentinel won't die. Oh, well, there goes that.
Not enough minerals.
Yeah. Oh, actually it's more like...
You must construct additional pylons.
We might actually just lose to the beatdown because... I almost forgot about you. Well, so much for feeling in a, like we're in a great position. The opponent is actually killing us just with his 2/2s. Leovold? Or another bear? Where did things go wrong? When probably when you didn't draw enough mana. Yeah. Because now we're going down to... yeah. That's... I guess we could Abrupt Decay one of the Deathrite Shamans, but we're still going down to 7, and then we're going guaranteed to go down to 5, and then we survive at 1 mana, at 1 life. So now we go down to 7, then we take 4, then we go down to 3, yeah, but... so we have to kill the Deathrite Shaman, unfortunately. And then we need to... well, I guess we can still win with Glimpse of Nature next turn. Like, we are going down to 1 life, unless he has got something else, but, like, yeah, they're not playing Rancor. Would be so awkward to, like, if this was your only creature and you cascaded into Rancor, and they're like, yeah, I'm not gonna play it. But we can win with Glimpse of Nature next turn, yeah. He's got 3 cards, unfortunately. And he hasn't played lands or creatures. Or, like, expensive creatures. Yeah, you're Abrupt Decay, Nettle Sentinel at some point. Oh no, he Fatal Pushed that one. Okay. Hmm. Oh, let's see. Maybe he's gonna show us something, but he tapped in a way that he doesn't have blue naturally from his lands. Also, he's got Forceful Pitch Shardless Agent. That doesn't really tell us anything. So, we could have played Natural Order, but that doesn't do anything because of Cage. Yeah, that felt a bit weird, but it's okay. Where is the rest of my deck? It's over here. Okay. And this one, and this one. So maybe I'm gonna take out one of these. But usually they only play one cage. I don't know. Yeah, but I'm still gonna do it like this. Because that might, like, the more Nettle Sentinels you have, the better your glimpses are. Maybe I can just set up a very quick glimpse kill. Who knows? Also, maybe like this. No, I still like this. It's not very likely that they have Cage early on, so I'm willing to gamble on that. I would like to play first, yes. Okay, this is something. This hand produces infinite mana. Well, not, I guess, infinite, but in an insane amount of mana on the second turn. And hopefully we'll be able to use it for something. Like, if we draw another 1 mana elf... oh, man. I don't know. Like, I really want to draw either Vilewood Symbiote or Elfish Visionary or another Senate on the next turn. And apart from that, like, we are going to have 7 power in play on the second turn, at least. Unless he has Fatal Push. Please don't have Fatal Push. Just let this be Deathrite Shaman. Meh! Okay, well, actually, it's not the worst because now Glimpse is my... oh, man, this would have been... This could have very likely been a turn 2 kill. instead... so we gotta make it so the Glimpse is great on the next turn, but we also gotta keep some creatures in hand. If I get... like, my first instinct was to get Deathrite Shaman here, but then we still have to play these anyway before we get to Glimpse, or we are, like, hoping to draw a land off one of the Glimpse draws, which we could do, but it's not likely. So maybe I'm just gonna... I think I'm gonna do it like this. It feels counterintuitive, but I also like how, like, if this works, we still have 4 power in play and get to pressure him a lot. And we still, like, draw 2 cards, like one for the turn, one for the glimpse, and then we probably draw another card because this can get viable symbiote. And I kind of like that position. And if he taps out for something that's like not proactive, like him, then we get to hit him down to 15. Then he plays, I don't know. Yeah, unfortunately, then he probably plays Shardless Agent, which would. Oh, okay. Nothing. And since you probably don't expect soft counters out of the stack, I'm just gonna lead with Glimpse Nature right away without playing a land. And he's got Force Pitch, Baleful Strix, okay. So now at this point, I'm scared. Like, there must have been a reason he kept this hand. You always, like, when you find yourself in a position like this where you feel like, oh my god, I'm very much, much advantaged. Why did the opponent keep this hand? His hand doesn't really look very strong, and he didn't. Okay, so he didn't play the Baleful Strix on the second turn, so it's probably his only blue card. Interesting. So I'm really scared of mass removal here, actually. So I might not do anything now. Oh, let's see, what's this gonna be? Okay, so that actually makes me think he doesn't have mass removal, because if he had mass removal, he probably wouldn't do that. Which means I'm gonna play it like this. And then probably fetch Dryad Arbor just for the additional beats, depending on whether he plays a blocker or not. And I really hope that I'm gonna draw Visionary or Viable Symbiote at some point, so I can turn this into the second missing piece. Draw anything like that on the next turn, I might just get Deathrite Shaman or a Visionary or Ooze. And I'm actually not sure yet, I wanna see what I'm gonna draw on the next turn. Okay, so maybe he kept his hand just because it looks good. Oh, Golgari Charm. Okay. Well, he's down to one mana, so that makes it much easier for us to resolve a Natural Order at some point in the future. I could also get Deathrite Shaman here. Like, Deathrite Shaman kills him rather quickly on this board. So maybe that's actually what I want to do. Also, that plays around him finding a cage on the next turn. Which would be like really bad for us because we need this card to do something. The Thought Shaman, yeah. So now he needs another land to activate Creeping Tar Pit, and that's like trading Creeping Tar Pit for this that wastes his entire turn and a land drop. Yeah, so I'm just gonna attack this in. I'm happy to draw to trade here. Yeah. The Stone Rain Time Walk. I'll take it. And then I'm gonna draw a card. And then. Am I gonna draw a card? I'm not sure. I think I'm actually not gonna draw a card now. I'm just gonna use Deathrite Shaman. Because now, if he has some kind of mass removal, or actually. No. No, I don't think he has mass removal. It's also too unlikely for him to draw into it. And I wanna get the beats on. And also, I could draw like another elf that I could play here, or Wywood Symbiote, for example. Or Natural Order. Yeah, I like that. Okay, next turn we have the kill, so he needs to find something. And if that something is Forceful, we are still very much ahead. So he needs. Exactly, Golgari Charm or Toxic Deluge. Right now it looks like he's got neither. Cradle maybe? That would make... Actually, I just want to draw Cradle here because it makes tapping for mana much easier. I'm lazy in this spot. He's got a stop on his end step. Is that like Golgari Charm? That would be the weirdest Golgari Charm in the world. Okay. Untap this guy, use this, and then I'm gonna sacrifice one of my visionaries, which is, okay, he's gonna kill this. So he's dead on board, should attack for exactly 16 now. Yeah, he should have killed this to play around Natural Order, but he didn't. So here comes
Finish the him!
Beast.
Carrier has arrived.
And we're gonna get them there for 16. He also doesn't have another black for anything like Fatal Push. And we got there. Okay, so we are 3-1. There's still 3 rounds to go. So see you next round, and hopefully we'll be able to clinch top 8.